You want to text alancoxshow.com. That's where you watch. Thanks again to who was helping us out today. Thank you to Hobby Jagushwesh for assisting in the video department. Guardians game shortly at 6:10. First of two against the Reds with Hammy and Rosie and the whole Hee Haw gang. If you need to get yourself some appropriate gear at CLE Clothing Company, you can do it. There's they got that new Gullardi shirt, more retro Buzzard merch, if you've seen any of us retweeting those. They're always dropping new pieces, and a whole wide array of things for you. I'd say suitable for casual or formal wear. Take your pick. But use a promo code MAYDAY, M-A-Y-D-A-Y, all through this month. You're about halfway through. All through the month of May, MAYDAY for 20% off at CLE Clothing Company. They've been kind of alluding to this or hinting at this for a while, but apparently they're pulling the trigger. McDonald's is leaving Russia for good after 30 years. This was a big deal. If you're old enough to remember...
I remember those videos when people were in line, like lines down the street to get into McDonald's.
1990, January of 1990, the first McDonald's got put into Moscow. And this was kind of seen as a, we were still in the Cold War, but it was kind of seen as like kind of a softening of relations a little bit, because it's American hamburgers and American, this was like, you know, Russia embracing the West. And so they've been there for 30 years. But given what's going on in Ukraine, McDonald's came to the conclusion that they can no longer make a case for staying in Russia. Now, what you're seeing is you're seeing Russian companies try to fill that vacuum with knockoff products. So once Coca-Cola split, there's Russian companies making like fake soda. Not, well, I mean, they're real sodas,
yeah,
but like, you know,
pushing their brand.
Facsimiles of whatever.
Cola Coca.
850 McDonald's were closed in March. They were all closed temporarily, they said. But, you know, I think a lot of these companies are like, well, let's see. Either Russia will defeat Ukraine in a month, because that's what they were waiting for. And they'll say it's, well, a humanitarian crisis and blah, blah, blah. But it's still a business. So they've said that they got a pullout after 30 years, that they will leave Russia because it's the right thing to do. And impossible to ignore the humanitarian crisis in Ukraine. Now, the question is, there's 62,000 people who work for McDonald's in Russia. And at the time in March, they were like, well, we're going to keep paying those people until we can figure out what to do. And I think they have to pay a little bit of money to get out of Russia. But that's a lot of people. But they're like, basically, they're going, we know it sucks, but we can't keep doing business.
Yeah.
Ukraine, and this is buried in the story, but this is the real answer. Russia and Ukraine accounted for 9% of McDonald's global sales. So they're like, look, we're not printing money
in these areas
anyway in Russia and Ukraine with McDonald's. There are 108 McDonald's restaurants in Ukraine. Those, of course, are closed still, but they're continuing to pay everybody.
What percentage of the United States does it, like McDonald's? Boy, I'm trying to phrase this and I can't think of how to phrase it.
How much? What percentage of sales does America account for?
There you go.
Probably. I don't know. I don't 70%. Have it in front of
me. Yeah, that's what.
Yeah.
Because like fast food overseas, like everyone wants to talk about when they go overseas, like, oh, I want something authentic. I want to get something that I can't get in America. McDonald's is nothing like the McDonald's in America. Like when you go overseas at like a McDonald's, they don't have the same menu items. So it actually is kind of like authentic. It's what they eat.
What McDonald's have you been to overseas?
I have friends that have visited overseas. I've never been overseas.
Mm-hmm.
I've never been to Europe, but they tell me like they have different type of French fries and different type of, like a hamburger is totally different over there.
Well, it's because they don't have cows running around. Like when I went to the subway in Ireland, in Dublin.
Oh yeah, I forgot you went there.
Yeah, I was like, that looks like meat.
What about chicken?
They have chicken.
But chicken's expensive.
It is?
You're much more likely to get kind of mystery meat overseas.
Really?
From what I understand,
in some places, I mean, not everywhere, but in the United States, McDonald's makes about $9 billion. So they make more money the rest of the world, but we account for about $9 billion of their...
So in the Philippines, they had all the stuff that you'd find on the American menu for the most part. But then they had other things that they'd add on. They had spaghetti. They had fried chicken.
I really wish we could have gone to that.
But you had Jollibee.
They also had Jollibee.
In Philippines.
Yeah. But
and I think they're starting to put those here.
Yeah, McDonald's was trying to compete with Jollibee. And Jollibee's fried chicken is incredible.
Yeah.
I'm a big fan of that. So the McDonald's, yeah, you get the you could get spaghetti. You could get, other things. Like, hamburgers aren't as big of a deal over there. They have them. But that's not usually what people are getting. They prefer the fried chicken and rice meal. And they had French fries. They tasted like French fries.
We have Jollibee in Chicago, and I tried it one time, and I was like, this is legit.
I'm really.
They have them in Canada, too.
What'd you get? Did you get a Jolly Burger? Whatever they
call
it.
No, I got chicken.
Yeah, the chicken's good.
Yeah, yeah.
Jollibee's hamburgers aren't great, but I always enjoyed the... They'd use banana ketchup on the burgers. Not a fan of that.
It's called Chicken Joy, what they serve you. And you can get, and it's this weird mix of like, hey, hamburgers, and here's chicken, but you get spaghetti with it.
Yeah.
And you go, okay.
Yeah, it's a free for all.
Probably still better than Skyline Chili.
Ain't that the truth?
Still never had it.
Well, just think of all the amazing things that there are still for you to experience, Poundcake.
I wish we could have gone to that KFC in Jamaica just to see what it was like.
I found out we're going back to Jamaica.
No, you didn't.
Yeah.
All of us?
No, me and Gwen.
Oh.
We got a wedding in the spring.
Another one in Jamaica?
Another one in Jamaica?
I thought you said...
Well, that one kept getting
that
moved.
That got COVID canceled.
Yeah.
They ended up getting married in Detroit.
I was going to say, because you originally said you were going in June.
Yeah.
Got COVID, pushed it back to, like, January, and then they pushed it back again to, like, June again.
Yeah, we had already decided we were bailing out of that, and they ended up getting married in Detroit. But
so not a show trip, though.
Correct.
Oh, who cares?
What part of Jamaica?
Ocho Rios!
Okay.
Just down the road from where we were in Montego Bay.
You say down the road, it was literally like an hour and a half. It was so long.
Yeah, but the country's not that big. I mean, 90 minutes is down the road. In a country? Yeah, that's...
You see a lot in that 90-minute drive. You see the most beautiful houses and then like the most ratchet slums.
Well, I didn't realize how long we were in that van because we kept stopping, and then Gwen was like, oh yeah, because we stopped halfway through to do like a thing, and then we got back in the van, and I was like,
we stopped halfway through to do a thing?
Didn't we? The mudding was halfway through, right?
No,
and then I thought we took the rest of the trip to Dunwoody Falls.
That was all in Ocho Rios. That's what we were going to Ocho Rios for.
Oh, really?
I don't remember.
We stopped because the girl got car sick.
Yeah, I remember
And that was the whole...
The puking and the buying the weed.
The weed experience.
Oh, that was the funniest thing
ever. It's still cringy to think about. I try to block that part out because...
Why? That's the best part.
No, because I feel so bad for the Jamaican.
Yeah, but it's one of the funniest parts of the whole trip.
I would have just gave him money. Like, I really...
Smoke weed every day.
Why didn't you then?
Well, I was already on thin ice with the stuff that I did there.
Yeah, but you hadn't done anything yet.
Yes, I did. That was the first night.
Yeah, first night he banged.
Oh, that's right.
We were on our trip, and it was a real quiet trip. Other than that, we saw a dead body. It was already very eventful on the second day. So yes, I did do it already.
Okay.
So I didn't want to also buy weed.
God.
Yeah, but you didn't have to buy weed. You could have just given the money, though. Say, I don't want any weed.
Right.
Okay.
That's what I'm saying. Well, you could have just given him money.
So if I wanted Coke, I would just be like, hey, Bill, I'm going to give you $10 to get me Coke, and then you give me Coke, and then technically I didn't buy it. Is that what you're doing?
No. What I'm saying is you said you felt bad for the Jamaican.
I did.
Because they didn't get their money.
Yes, but he peeled out so fast.
$5.59.
Peeled.
Pulled it out. Oh, boy. What a way to end.
Yep.
Oh, the best. Anyway, I saw they're putting a Shake Shack by where I live, my neck of the woods.
I've still never been to Shake Shack.
I haven't either. But there's one downtown near the new studios.
Once we're downtown, I'm sure I'll give it a try.
There you go. All right. Okay, we got to go. Guardians game in minutes. First of two against the Reds right downtown at the corner of... God, I know it'll come to me. Anyway, Bill, what do you have coming up?
May 28th, I'm doing a show at Hilarities. It's called Stand and Deliver. It is a comedy contest where two comedians compete writing jokes with suggestions they get from the audience. It's a lot of fun. So check out that show.
The holiday tickets. Weekend.
Yeah, get tickets at hilarities.com. And then follow me on Twitter and Instagram at Bill Squire. Check out High and Dry Comedy Hour this Thursday at 9 p.m. now. We're starting a little later because waiting for that sun to get down. And then check out the Bill Squire Show podcast on iHeartRadio.
Poundcake.
Radio Cody B, Twitter, Instagram, TikTok. Latest Poundcake podcast at alancoxshow.com. New one tomorrow. And a Poundcake sports break. So you have that to look forward to.
A lot of stuff. Okay, cool. Thanks, guys. I'm out there at Alan Cox Show, Twitter, Instagram, Cameo, on TikTok, Facebook, The Alan Cox Show, and YouTube as well if you want to watch the show. If you want to leave us a message, you can do it, whether you listen live or on the podcast on the iHeartRadio app. Use the talkback button if you want to drop a voicemail. After Hours line is still available to you. It's 216-986-8903. And that's it. We'll talk to you again tomorrow on 2 o'clock. Thank you very much for hanging out today. And a Guardians game is next. I will see you in hell.
And now I must leave you as the Brady Bunch.